Hello, gorgeous. My name is Dusty, and this is the Scorpio Priestess. If you like my vibe, give me a like and a subscribe. Anybody who has, thank you. It means a lot to me. If you have donated to my channel in any way, thank you. This is a general collective read. We are seeing who is coming towards you in love. What do they want? And who is this person? What do they want, right? What is coming towards you in love? If you would like a personal reading, you can visit ScorpioPriestess.com. I would love to read for you. I not only have FaceTime reads and video reads, I also have a tarot and talk. It is a motivational coaching read. If you are looking to remove some blockages, find a game, set a game plan on how to move forward, how you should be moving forward, that would be the reading for you. So let's get into this. Who is coming towards you? Well, somebody who is scared and paranoid. This person has low self-esteem due to their upbringing. They are paranoid. They're paranoid you're going to reject them. They are paranoid here that you are not going to say yes to them. They are progressing, but very slowly. This person has been trying to manifest you back. You possibly have been feeling very pulled to this person. They've been pulling on your energy. I sense here that this person thinks about you so much that you are constantly thinking about them, like you feel pulled to them. You could start feeling good, and then all of a sudden you start getting pulled back down. And it's because this person is trying to manifest you back. Tell me about this scared person spirit. So they are scared, they are paranoid, they're paranoid you're going to reject them. They overindulge here. They have a lot of emotional baggage. This person could be a player. And they crave you. They tap into your sexual energy here. This person literally has an intense sexual pull to you. They're manifesting you. Like I said, I feel like you feel this person. You can feel them thinking of you. You can feel them pulling on your energy. I feel they always keep a lot of options because of their upbringing, because of due to low self-esteem. They're always needing filled somewhere, and they've never been filled like you filled them, right? They could overeat. They could do something. They could drink too much, use too much. They could do something too much. They always need filled. This person is very overindulgent. They are greedy with their energy, though. They will only give so much of them. And it's all because of this low self-esteem that they deal with from childhood. They could have anger issues as well, but they are progressing. I feel here you're trying to cut the cord. You're slowly progressing away from this person because they're in some karmic situation. There's some lessons to be learned here. And I sense that you're trying to release this because it was very toxic. I also feel this person could call you names, curse you out, right? Have some violent tendencies about them. They could smash things when something happens between you all. They could really start getting crazy. They could have scared you a few times, or they could have smashed your phone. I'm just seeing somebody like they're throwing a phone, smashing a phone, punching a hole in the wall. There's something here this person does or did that scared you. And so you are slowly trying to, yeah, they were a fake lover. They're secretly jealous of you and your success, though. This person here could be trying to manifest more money in their life, manifest being more like you, but they don't know how to harness energy like you. They're not spiritual. They don't understand how energy works. I feel this person doesn't understand manifestation. They could actually be trying to learn how to manifest, right? Trying to learn, but nothing seems to be manifesting in their life because they're overindulgent, because they always keep a lot of options. They have anger issues. Their vibration is so low. Nothing is manifesting in their life. They're not able to manifest anything. Tell me about this person's spirit. Yeah, this person thinks you're beautiful but spoiled, handsome but spoiled, right? They're very interested in money. This could be a person in a feminine energy. They breadcrumbed you. They gave you nothing but crumbs. They would call you for a booty call a lot of the times. I feel like this person here could have really made you feel like you were this big. They're very sexual. Their sexual energy is poisonous. Please be careful. This person here is very toxic, very abusive and manipulating. I feel they could be in a codependent relationship, or they have codependent people around them. They are always dependent on somebody else making them feel a certain way. Like they need to feel like they're wanted or chased all the time. This person here has extreme passion for you. But the thing is they want to have makeup sex. They could call you for a booty call very, very soon. I feel this person, if they are with a third party, they are falling out of love with this third party here. There's possibly, they're not in a relationship. They only have sexual connections. They're unrealistic here as well. This person here is unhealthy. They have unhealthy choices, and you need to trust your instincts here. I feel it's time for you to speak to possibly a friend or a professional here, because this person has fucked you all the way up. I'm so sorry if that is the case here. I will pray for you. I feel this person has really hurt you, and you have done and done and done trying to get this person to take you serious, trying to get them to love you. But, and it's not that they don't, it's just that that's all they do is have sexual connections. They're very reckless in their sexual energy, very reckless, to the point where now it has hurt you. I feel you became codependent. Yeah, it's so burdensome. You've became codependent on them. And please do not value your self-worth on them. Don't look at yourself and or allow yourself to feel less than because this person doesn't treat you well. You are perfect. You are nothing's wrong with you. It's this person and their low self-esteem is what I'm saying. Of course, nobody's perfect, but I'm saying there's nothing wrong with you. It's this person and their low self-esteem. There's burdens, there's suffering, there's sorrow, there's guilt. You all could have religious differences as well. You could have different, you'd be from different backgrounds. You could have relocated. This person could have, you all, this could be a long distance relationship. You could have vacationed with this person at one time. You thought everything was going to be great, and it turned out it was not. They have a lot of nostalgia. The past is definitely returning here. There's family issues though. There's something that happened to this person during their childhood that really affected them. I feel here they want you to cooperate with them. They're going to come in and be very sweet to you. It's anywhere from now until August. This could be an Aries. This could be a Virgo. Anywhere now until August, this person, yeah, they want to bring you some gift or give you some invitation. Again, with Virgo energy. There's something fated to happen here. This person could be having an actual breakthrough, a revelation, but it's karma, it's fate. I feel here you've unlocked something inside this person. If you've been wanting an answer to something, or you've been wanting this person to answer you, I'm hearing answer me. You may call this person and they don't answer, or you may ask them something and they refuse to answer. You're going to get this answer. Okay, for some of you, somebody here could have pink in their hair. You could have pink highlights or pink hair, or did at one time. I feel this person here, something is coming in very fast. They're coming in to communicate, but they're still lying. They still have hidden intentions in some way. It's going to accelerate very quickly though. Yeah, you need to think strategically. You're being guided to cut this person out and be patient with yourself. Now, we all have free will here, but the thing is this person paints illusions and they make you feel like you're in an illusion. I sense that, again, they are trying to manifest you. This could be a air sign. This could be a Sagittarius, a earth sign. There's a difficult decision that's going to have to be made here in love regarding this person. This person's going to come in and tell you that they want to build a foundation. They want to build with you. there is about to be a lucky twist of fate, and your the fruits of your labor are coming in because of dealing with this situation, because of all the burdens that this person has put you under, and you have stayed, you know, with pure intentions. Tell me about fate and karma, spirit. Karma is here, y'all. All right. You could be a water sign. You're very intuitive. You're very compassionate. This person could do well for themselves. They could be a playboy or a playgirl, right? They could just run around here in this destructive energy. You, again, I just clarified this with earned reward. You making a judgment call to stand in your power here, to listen to your intuition, is going to bring in some earned reward, possibly a brand new lover, Ace of Cups. But this person wants to come in and bring this shit back from the dead. They're destructive and they're indulgent. You could possibly still be dealing with this person on and off. You could hear from them once a month, once every couple weeks. They could be doing something like that. There is a needed change. Spirit is saying, please walk away. This routine is stagnant and you need a change. You can't keep doing this with this person. Ten of Cups here. Listen, if you walk away from this, you are going to get the Ten of Cups, Ace of Cups, a beautiful, loving relationship. That is what you will get from karma and fate. But there's a difficult decision, and only you can make it. If you allow, when somebody has a very low vibration like this person, and you entangle yourself with them, you can start taking on their karma. You can start taking on their vibration. Most of the time, you will lower your vibration. They will not raise theirs, guys. That's how this works, okay? So please know that. I feel you're going to move forward, though, and go into rapid fire planning. You're going to be like, I'm doing this, I'm doing that, and I'm doing this. I'm moving forward. I'm not doing this anymore. There's going to be a shift in your energy really soon. This could definitely be a fire sign, a lot of fire here. I feel for a lot of you, you definitely are going to go through a completion with this person and walk away and leave all of these eight cups. Yes, eight cups is a lot of love, but spirit is saying, please allow this to unfold naturally. Okay, because this person wants to give your partnership a chance, but divine timing is at work in your love life, and there's somebody new possibly entering other than this person that you're going to want to get to know. You're definitely going to feel a lot of attraction towards a new person, but your self-respect makes you more romantically attractive. And honestly, y'all, when you start healing these inner child issues, these family issues, when you start breaking these generational curses, you are going to move into a very committed long-term connection with somebody. But the divine is asking you to allow this to unfold naturally, meaning if this person stops talking to you, don't bother them. Let it go. Just move forward. Don't keep, you know, and then if they try to come back, don't. Stop the cycle here is what they're asking you to do. You attract more romantic love as you enjoy this moment fully. Start living in the present moment. Stop being so concerned about the future and don't focus on the past is what you're being guided to do. Cut the cord. Release this toxic love. I'm waiting for the right time and I fantasize about how life would be with you. Yeah, there's something about divine timing here. This person wants to come in. They feel right in the right time. For some of you, they're trying to put time in between you all because something went down. They acted a fool. They did something. You found out something about them. So they're trying to give you time to calm down about something. But please remember, loving yourself first is so important. Your self-respect makes you more attractive. It makes you more attractive to everybody, even this person. Allowing them to just run in and out of your life is not doing you any justice, it looks. But we all have free will, and it's, you know, sometimes we got to go through it a couple times to learn our lessons. No shame, right? Lord knows I've been there. I hope you have a beautiful and blessed day. Tell yourself every day and every way, I get better and better. I am a winner. All I do is win. Love and light.